May 23rd, 2016. It's 6:25 p.m. And come on here to show you. We got three burgundy okra growing here. Let me get over in a minute more. Three burgundy okras there. You know, I'm not going to zoom them all in, but just showing them. We got them all throughout here. We got spineless green okra too. All told, we got 13 right now coming up. The corn over here, we got three rows of 12 I planted. We did 3 weeks apart, except for the last time I just did after 2 weeks. Right down here is less 12. Nothing's come up out of that. But of all the others, of the 24 holes we had, I think it's 22 are growing. Maybe 21. Petey, stay out of there, please. So that'll be sweet corn. It's heirloom corn, too, by the way. I mean, Monsanto is the biggest threat to that, and they're not growing Monsanto corn this year around us. So that's the only reason I planted this corn. And I have sunflowers all over the garden, too. Doing my sunflower fence, as you can see around the edge there. Over there, some. And CJ's grave. And we got the yellow sunflowers mixed in with the torch sunflowers. Going all the way around three sides of the garden. But anyway, see, we got one here. Got one down there, one there. And like I say, the bees, butterflies will come on these. Honeybees, I want to say bees. And then we had them last year. I put a tea bag down there for this because it should help with this this white spot. If it's not any better, it's going to rain tomorrow, I believe. I might mix up a tablespoon of baking soda in with filtered water and spray on the leaves. Because that's the only thing I put on there that I did it last year, and it really cleared it up pretty well, too. All these had white spot on them. This one, too, this big one. But I put down two tea bags on this total. I did one when I did all the others, and I just put a second one down yesterday. You can see there's virtually no white spot left on here. And we have the golden zucchini down there. You see those two little zucchinis? I got pumpkin planted down there. Nothing coming up out of that yet. Oh, and this other zucchini, this golden zucchini, I think there was another one over here. Yeah, you can barely see. I can see with my naked eye. You can see the yellow down there. That's the golden zucchini right in the center. And then over here, you can see that golden zucchini down there. There. And there's another one there. There's two of them there. This is the classic green zucchini or black beauty. And I don't see anything on that one yet. Amazingly, somehow or another, we only had one seed for this. I don't understand how that worked, but that's what we have. And I'm just going to go with that. Then we have, there's two straight eight cucumbers in that one place. One over there. Right down there. And then one in the corner there. Okay. And that one. I planted them here, but this is grass. So I'm going to pull that grass up. I've been out here picking grass out by hand. More sunflowers around the edge. We planted marigolds. Maybe about 18 or so inches apart all around the edges here. And there's grass all over it now, too. But there are marigolds planted from seed. And here's my east sunflower fence. These are about 3 feet tall. Petey, come back over here, buddy. Come on, you don't want no ticks on you. See my sunflower. It gets low right in here. I don't understand that. Why here? Because this area here is more shaded, but that's about 3 feet tall. This is about maybe 12, 18 inches and 24 inches. Then we have watermelon right down there in the corner. I planted watermelon and cantaloupe in these other two holes, but nothing's coming up out of there yet. Walked down here about 15 feet. Planted watermelon and cantaloupe down here. Now, according to this, there should be a watermelon and cantaloupe there and a cantaloupe there. But they all basically look the same to me. This is the very farthest east row of number three. I have an okra planted down in that hole. You can see I have one plant there, it's coming up. One right there coming up. I'm in the back row here. I'm just gonna go down the back. Now I go back into the middle. I don't know if I planted one there. I think I did, but I'm not sure. This one I didn't. This one I did. You can see it right there too. Right there's your okra. Oh, see what sunflowers here, how big these are? These are 3 feet. Just a little bit right here up against the garden. But the rest of them are in that back there. That's about, I got that about 8 feet back from the garden all the way down. And like I said, they'll attract butterflies and honeybees. Here's another okra. Right down there. And I got one on the outside of the plastic. Right there. Okay, that's okra. And I got my little sun at night. This is kind of cool. Lights up out here. I'd like to afford 2 more of these solar lights, spotlights. But my sunflower, look at that, all facing the sun as the sun sets. They all go just facing that way. With tomatoes, with the wind and the tactics, we got some that are still making it last. And there's one right down there. That's one. Two over there. 3. That one's hanging in there. I'm not really going to count that though. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Up in front there, 9. That's it, 9. Well, see, we have flowers on some of these, but we actually have 3 or 4 tomatoes on this one here. Where's it at now? So I didn't see, yesterday my friend was here from Illinois, and we looked at them, and I see, like I said, flowers on here. That one there. I don't know if I can get on the camera there. You know, the leaves are curled because the wind out here has been so bad. With this one here, as you can see, we got tomato there. Got one there. Again, I can't see on this viewfinder if I'm doing this. Right there, right down there. 3, there's one there. There's 3 tomatoes on here. At least. And so far we're doing good without the hornworms. We put down the coffee grounds to prevent them. Coffee grounds will keep them out. And I'm suckering these as it gets bigger. So, got some nice little green tomatoes on here right now. Cut those, take those in and fry them up. But then my beans here aren't doing as well as I thought they would. They're doing okay, but I planted where that grass is, I planted bean there. I thought I planted a bean here. I'm pretty sure I did. Planted one there. But I got that one. I mean, they're sporadic, and they're different varieties, too. In the earlier videos, you'll see the white and the black and the Trail of Tears Cherokee and so forth. So right now, plants that are coming up, I have 2 in that first hole, 2, 3, 4 in that one there, 5, 6. 7. Is it just one? I can't really see. 7. Yeah, 7. This one I can't tell if there's 2 here. 7. 8, 9. There's 2 in there. 9. 2 in here. Let's say I pull up this grass. What I've been doing by hand. Gotta pull it up by hand. 9, that's 11. 12, 13. Wow, I can't see right there. 12, 13. 14, 15, 16 over there. Oh, 17, 18. This is 1, 18. Yep, 19. 19 bean plants planted. I need to build 5 more fences. We'll see, when there's none here coming up, I might end up just taking these and moving them over to the ones that are coming up. So 19 beans are coming up. And that's it. The okra, the corn, the non-existent pumpkin yet, the golden zucchini, and the traditional green zucchini, which is Black Beauty. Cucumbers, my tomatoes, and then my beans, and the watermelon and cantaloupe on the very end over there, and the sunflowers all the way around. So It is the 23rd of May, 2016. It's about 6:30 now p.m. So this is the way it should be. As you see, the plastic I have tied around my tomato steaks are basically docile, which is the way they should be. A little breeze is fine, but all the last month, well, actually for the last year and a half, I would say, we've had constant winds. That's why my tomato plant leaves are curled so much, because of the wind out here. All these have been grown from seed in the house, come out. When they came out, they were half about the size of this one right here. Okay, that's what we usually bring when we come out. Most people buy them from the store looking like that right there when they transplant them. We come out of the house right out like that, you know, so they're about 8 inches tall, real thin. We put them out here. Epsom salt and water, with 2 tablespoons of Epsom salt and 1 tablespoon of sugar to a gallon of water. And you feed that to your tomatoes once every two to three weeks. You know, and I mean, don't just douse it. You pour it in the ground there to soak it down into the roots. That's what helps keep them healthy. And now that the wind has stopped here, finally, after all this time, for the last 2 days now, it's been really steady. Yesterday was a little breezy, but not as bad. And it's getting better now, so. Oh, there's a pumpkin. I forgot about this pumpkin. Because this was messed up. We thought it was zucchini over here last year. And it turned out it was pumpkins. So, when we were pulling them all up and all this, because they were really messed up and they had disease on them, so we got rid of them. And then one of the seeds must have fell there and it's pulling out this. So we're going to let the pumpkin come on out this way. And these are flowers I put down. Torch sunflowers mainly. And then there's flowers I had bought from Heirloom Solutions, which is a great place to get your heirloom seeds. See those ones there, they look like another one. It looks similar to a weed, but it's not. These are the heirloom flowers when they come up. All the flowers I bought have medicinal purposes. They're herbs, and they benefit the garden. And like I said, they attract butterflies. They attract honeybees. They attract the large winged butterflies, by the way, not just regular butterflies, but the large winged ones. Which, if you look at some of the past videos, you see the orange-like flowers. That's your torch sunflowers. You'll see the large ones. Like, and we got some monarchs out here, even. So the peppers over there, I'm not going to do on this video, but I have a lot of times we've got these bluebirds out here that have been so pretty lately. Where's it at now? There they are. Look at those bluebirds. We have cardinals out here a lot. Lots of hummingbirds. We've got, I think we got 8 feeders out now, 6 or 8 feeders. At the current right now, we have about 20 hummingbirds. Including right back here, we put a feeder in the back of the garden, right over CJ's grave. Every time I hear that donkey, I keep thinking of Star Wars. But yeah, these bluebirds are really pretty. Has some yellow or American finches, I think they're called, yellow and black finches. Oh, there's 3 bluebirds. That's not bluebird. What did I do with them? Where is that feeder at now? See, I just got off of the subject here. Oh, there it is. Yeah, see, they're picking through the food and dropping it on the ground. The other birds will get over there and eat on that. Focus. Why aren't you focusing? I got ants crawling on my arms and stuff. Yeah, I've been sitting out here lately. Hummingbirds go up here into these bare branches and everything over our head. Bluebirds flying back and forth. Cardinals are coming back and forth. So it's really nice out here.